Surprise,
Yes.
Number 7.
I want to make country.
Amen. Number 7. My eyes is consumed because of grief. It vexed old because of all my enemies. Number 8.
For the Lord has heard my voice of my weeping.
Number 9. The Lord have heard my supplication. The Lord will remember, will receive my prayer. Number 10 together, please.
Let all my enemies be ashamed. Let them turn and be ashamed suddenly.
Amen. Pick number 9. The Lord have heard my supplication. The Lord will remember, will receive my prayer. I pray that Almighty God continue to receive our prayers and respond to our prayers in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And bless us for our call to the for praise and worship. Let us pray. Eternal Father, our mother, Redeemer, Jesus Christ, the Son of the Living God, our Daddy, our Maker, Father, we worship. Lord, this moment we say, may your name be glorified. Father, we give you glory, honor, adoration because of who you are. Daddy, the hour has come to give to you that which you cannot give to yourself. Father, your message says us, O Lord, whether we are not qualified, make us to be qualified. Any sin you can find in us that the devil is accusing us of, Father, please, in your mercy, wipe it away from us in the name of Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit, I step aside and hand over to you in Jesus Christ's mighty name. Amen. We are on the Lord's side. We never give up. We are overcomers. For the Lord God is on our side. Our God is on our side. We are on the Lord's side. Belongs to you, Lord. belongs to you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Living God,
Abiesi asekwe me papa. Worship the Lord, magnify His holy name.
Father, Lord, in the name of Jesus, we
worship the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Brethren, it's time for our prayer. God, let us pray. Everlasting Father, we thank you. We glorify your holy name. Mighty God, everlasting King, you are worthy to be praised, O Lord. Father, Lord, we thank you. We, your children, have come before your holy throne of mercy. Father, please, as we are about to pray, we pray that you are here. Prayer, so God. Is there any sin in us that will make our prayers not to be acceptable in their sight? Father, please have mercy and deliver us in Jesus Christ's mighty name we are praying.
Amen.
Our first prayer point on the Thanksgiving. Our Bible reading will be the book of Leviticus, chapter 19, verse 8. Leviticus 19:17, please.
I read in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thy heart. Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor and not suffer sin upon him. Amen.
Amen.
And the prayer point goes thus. Thank you, Jesus Christ, for giving us the grace not to hate our brothers. In Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Father, Lord Almighty, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord.
Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ,
Our Bible reading will be taken from the book of Leviticus 17. Leviticus 17, ma.
The Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Is this Abu Zade?
Yes,
sir. Sir. Is that the place? Yes, sir.
Internet. Leviticus
17. 17, Leviticus 19:17.
Leviticus 19:17, I read in Jesus' name. Amen. Thou shalt not hear thy brother in thy heart. Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor and not suffer sin upon him. Amen.
Amen. I'm going to thank God this way. Thank you, Jesus Christ, for showing us how to rebuke our neighbors and not to suffer sin upon them. In Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen. Father, I give you the
name of Jesus Christ. Our Father, and God, thank you, Jesus Christ, oh Lord, for showing us to rebuke our neighbors, oh Lord, and not to suffer sin upon them.
We move over to Mercy number 20, and our Bible reading will be taken from the book of Mark 5, verse 8 to 9, please.
I read in Jesus' name.
Amen.
8. For he said unto him, Come out of the man, thou unclean spirit. 9. And he asked him, What is thy name? And he answered, saying, My name is Legion, for we are many. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And the prayer point goes thus. Please have mercy on me, Lord Jesus, and deliver me from any evil company living with me, knowingly and unknowingly, in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Move over to Mercy number 21, Bible reading. Philippians 4 verse 9, please. Philippians 4 verse 9.
I read in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Those things which you have both learned and received and heard and seen in me do, and God of peace shall be with you. Amen.
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 Brethren, we are going to cry out for mercy this way. Please have mercy on me, Lord Jesus. In any way I have made anyone bitter towards holiness due to my conduct, please restore such people, O God, in Jesus Christ's merciful name. General prayer 105, Bible reading, 1 Corinthians 15, verse 19, please. First Corinthians 15, verse 19.
I read in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
19. If in this life only we have hope in Christ, we are of all men most miserable. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We're going to pray this way. I refuse to have hope in this sinful world. but to focus on Christ alone in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Last but not the least, on general prayer number 106, Bible reading Revelation 22, verse 5, please.
I read in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And there shall be no night there, and they need no candle, neither light of the sun, for the Lord God giveth them light, and they shall reign forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
I'm going to pray this way. Oh Lord, my Father, please, in your glorious and beautiful kingdom, may I and my entire family live with you forever and ever in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen. Father, Lord,
in Jesus Christ's mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
And as we have all prayed, so shall it be as we cover all the prayer points with the blood of Jesus Christ.
Blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
So when it's time for Bible reading by the special grace of God, Bible reading is taken from the book of Luke 16. Luke chapter 16, I read. And he said also unto his disciples, there was a certain rich man which had a steward, and the same was accused unto him that he had wasted his goods too. And he called him and said unto him, how is it that I hear this of thee? Give an account of the stewardship, for thou mayest be no longer steward. Verse 3. Then the steward said within himself, what shall I do? For my Lord taketh away from me the stewardship. I cannot dig. To beg, I am ashamed. Verse 4. I am resolved what to do, that when I am put out of the stewardship, they may receive me into their house. Verse 5. So he called every one of his lost debtors unto him, and he said unto the first, how much owest thou unto my Lord? Verse 6. And he said, 100 measure of oil. And he said unto him, take that bill and sit down quickly, write 50. Verse 7. Then said he to another, and how much owest thou? And he said, 100 measure of the wheat. And he said unto him, take that bill and write fourscore. Verse 8, and the Lord commanded the unjust steward, because he had done wisely, for the children of the world are in their generation wiser than the children of the light. Amen.
9, and I say unto you, make to yourselves friends of the mammon of unrighteousness, that when you fail, they may receive you into everlasting habitations. 10, he that is faithful in that which is least is faithful also in much, and he that is unjust in the least is unjust also in much. 11. If therefore you have not been faithful in the unrighteous mammon, who will commit to your trust the true riches? 12. And if you have not been faithful in that which is another man's, who shall give you that which is your own? 13. No servant can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he will hold to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and mammon. 14. And the Pharisees also, who were covetous, heard all these things, and they dreaded him. 15. And he said unto them, ye are they which justify yourselves before men, but God knoweth your hearts, for that which is highly esteemed among men is abomination in the sight of God. 16. The law and the prophets were until John. Since that time, the kingdom of God is preached, and every man presseth into it. Amen.
17. And it is easier for heaven and earth to pass than one little of the law to fail. Whosoever away his wife and marry another committed adultery, and whosoever marry her that is put away from her husband committed adultery. 19. There was a certain rich man which was clothed in purple and fine linen and fared sumptuously every day. 20. And there was a certain beggar named Lazarus, which was lay at his gate, full of sore. 21. And desiring to be fed with the crumbs which fell from the rich man's bread and lick his sore. 22. And it came to pass that the beggar died and was buried by Abraham's bosom. The rich man died and was buried. 23. And he in torment, and Abraham is bosom. He cried and said, Father Abraham, that he may dig deep of his finger in water and cool my tongue, for I am tormented in this flame. Amen.
Verse 25. But Abraham said, Son, remember that thou in thy lifetime received thy good things, and likewise Lazarus evil things, but now he is comforted and thou art tormented. Verse 26. And beside all this, between us and you there is a great gulf fixed, so that they which would pass from hence to come to you cannot, neither can they pass to us that would come from thence. Verse 27. Then he said, I pray thee therefore, Father, that thou shouldest send him to thy father's house. 28. For I have five brethren, and he that he may testify unto them, lest they also come unto this place of torment. Verse 29. Abraham said unto him, they have Moses and the prophets, let them hear them. 30. And he said, nay, Father Abraham, but if one went unto them from the dead, they will repent. 31, the last verse. And he said unto him, if they hear not Moses and the prophets, neither will they be persuaded, though one rose from the dead. Amen. May the Lord bless the reading of his word in our heart, in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Beloved, we are all welcome to the presence of our Father once again to come and tarry in his presence. Beloved, thank you for his mercy. Before we give God all the glory and pray for mercy and pray for our children, let us begin to set our soul, spiritual body on fire, set every environment on fire, commend the gathering into the hands of God, that the Lord God Almighty should take charge, hide this gathering in the hollow of Jesus' hands, hide our soul, spiritual body in the hollow of Jesus' hands. Every soul that have present here, even the one that could not be able to connect, we are going to hide every soul in the hollow of Jesus' hands, in Jesus Christ's mighty name. Mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Lord, let's open our mouth and magnify the name of our God. Let's thank him, worship him, give him all the praise for the privilege he has given to us to come and gather in his presence. Let's thank him because we are complete. That is the most important, that we are complete, that no one is missing. Let's give him praise because we have not heard bad news from our families. Let's worship him for taking care of us, building the world of protection around us all in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Father, we thank you because no one is thank you for your protection, Lord Jesus. We give
you
we give you all the praise. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. We worship you,
Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Savior. Thank you, King of Kings. Thank you, Lord God Almighty. In the name of Jesus Christ, next up in your holy name. In Jesus Christ, in the name we pray.
Amen.
Beloved, we are still quickly going to thank God. We are going to bless his holy name. Thank you for every soul on this mountain. Thank you for the body of Christ. Thank you for the lovers of Christ, the believers that believe in Christ, that is following his footsteps. We are going to give him all the praise for giving us the grace to serve him in repentance. In the name of God, many think they are serving God because they are serving God unrepented. They are wearing garment on top of unclean garments. Let's thank him for purifying us, giving us the grace to serve him in repentance. Bless his holy name in Jesus Christ's mighty name. Amen. Amen. Beloved, we are going to ask God for mercy, that the Lord God Almighty should have mercy upon every soul on this mountain. We are going to pray for ourselves, also pray for members that are not present. Let us pray that the Lord God Almighty should search us, since he formed us in our mother's womb. Let him search us, anything in our life, anything that does not glorify God in our lives, in the life of our family members, in the life of our children, that the devil, that the accuser or brethren is accusing us of, that is using to pollute us, that thing that is giving him access, let God have mercy upon us and take it away from us. And purify us, wash us as white as snow in Jesus Christ's mighty name. Pray for our children. Pray for
Amen. 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 My Father, Lord Jesus, Lord Jesus Christ,
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. In Jesus Christ. We are still good for, we are good for mercy. The Lord should have mercy upon us and stand against every strong man. Beloved, our Lord God created us. He also expect, as he created us, he brought us, he sent us to this world for a purpose. He expect us to finish and return back to him. Therefore, heaven is our home because we came from there. Praise Master Jesus. We are going to pray at every forces of darkness, powers of darkness, strong men from our father's side, from my mother's side, from my mother's side, from the pit of hell, that how that we will not return to our maker, that our members will not go back to our maker, and our power and be consumed in the name of
Jesus.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus Christ's name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. We are quickly going to pray for our children. We are going to commit our children of God, because I was sleeping and we are here, we are in the battlefield. Every power that have saw us gathered against us, they could not be able to penetrate, and they want to try to want to come and afflict our children, pursue them in their dream of to try to feed in the cut off and let those power wither to hell by fire in Jesus Christ.
Amen. Father, God,
Jesus Christ, we pray. Pray for our people. Pray for the God of my move. The move. Walls of Jericho standing against their the purpose of God in their life. Any hindrance, anything that will stand as hindrance to the purpose of God in the life of our children, as long as they live, let God arise and demolish it in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us pray. In the name of Jesus Christ, be consumed. Let it be consumed.
In the name of Jesus,
send me your holy name. In Jesus Christ, we pray.
Amen.
Amen. We cover this session with the precious blood of Jesus Christ.
The blood of Jesus Christ.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God bless you, man of God. More grace and strength of God upon your life, sir, in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Lovely. We're going to pray for the youths, teenagers, and the pregnant women. And by the grace of God Almighty, we're firstly praying for the pregnant woman, because the time of pregnancy is it's a very sensitive time for the woman. And also, as a given labor, it's also a sensitive time. When a woman is given birth to the child, you know, it's very stressful and it's very painful for the woman. And at that time, if the woman is not careful, she can say things that she doesn't want to say. She can, you know, curse, she can do this, say that, say something that she should not say that may be used against the woman. So our prayer that we're going to pray today, we're also going to pray for ourselves in case in future when God Almighty, you know, gives us a baby, that whatsoever women have said in the past or are going to say out of anger, out of frustration, in that time of pregnancy, in that time of labor, that the enemy wants to use against them, that Father, in your mercy, please enter them, O God, and help the women not to say the things that will be used against them, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Please pray if you understand.
Amen. Let the blood of Jesus
Amen. And I pray that even considering this same prayer point of reason, I pray that whenever, if we have ever said, you know, at that time of pregnancy where we have done it out of stress, that, you know, this is going to be the last one, this is the last child I have, you know, out of frustration. Anyway, we have said that, may God Almighty have mercy and help us to see the writings in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Still praying for the pregnant women. We're going to pray. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Still praying for the pregnant women. One thing that, one evil that is going on in the world is that a man and woman is living together. And a woman is carrying pregnancy for another man. But this woman will be pretending as if she's carrying the pregnancy for the husband. And that's how it will go and go and go and go. And the man will not know. That is a great evil. We're going to pray. As many women are like that, who are carrying pregnancy for another woman out of adultery, out of committing sin, and the husband does not know. And this evil is going on. That God, in your mercy, help that woman, oh God, to confess as she ought to tell the man of the evil that she done, because this is a great sin. And let's pray that God might will do that, and it shall not happen again in the name of Jesus Christ. Please pray for us. Beloved, now we're going to pray for the youths and teenagers. You know, these youths and teenagers are, by the grace of God Almighty, God will permit, they will be the one that will carry on with this ministry. They'll be the one that will now take over. We're going to pray that our youths, our teenagers, will not, you know, will not walk in sin. That as they're carrying this ministry, they will not carry it in sin. The way Eli's sons, you know, they were in sin, but they were still Eli's son. That God, in your mercy, the youth, oh God, that they're going to carry this ministry tomorrow, they will not carry it in sin. They're not carrying it in unrighteousness. That God will help them to be holy and righteous, and even help us as well to be holy and righteous in this present time, in the name of Jesus Christ. Please, let's pray.
Amen. I'm going to go to the hospital.
the name of Jesus, any power that will put back in the world, I was in the world, but away from that one.
Jesus, who, when they come inside the church of God, they are committed or trusted to different types in the church. They are in the house of God. You know, these things, it can happen. This thing is really happening, you know, in the church where you are seen in the house of God. We're going to know that in any way this is happening, that Father, have mercy upon them. Do not destroy them in your wrath. As many youths are engaged in the church, in your house, upon them, and eyes to see the evil of their ways in the name of Jesus Christ. Peace and good.
Amen.
Teenagers, we pray for wisdom, love, for this age makes God we're making. You know, the prayer points the man of God is raising today, isn't that the mistakes we made in our youth? So we're going to pray for God to also give youth wisdom to not commit, you know, these sins, these mistakes that we have made, that we're now praying again, that God deliver us, that the youth will not make the same mistake we made, that they will have wisdom to learn from life experiences and live a holy and righteous life in the name of Jesus Christ. Please, let's pray.
Amen. Father, my Lord, my God, Jesus Christ, our God, Baba, we commit to God, Baba.
Father, Lord,
And as we have prayed, so shall it be in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Prayer points, all the prayer points are covered in the blood of Jesus Christ, in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Bless you, Jesus.
Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
God bless you, servants of Most High God. More grace, more strength of God upon your lives in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Love God, in this section of the prayer, we're going to pray. Every nation of the world now need our prayer seriously. We're going to pray for nations. We as well, as time permits us, we're going to pray for our families as well as the servants of God all over the world, all the true servants of God. First of all, we're going to pray for nations. We're going to pray, we'll see what is happening today. Many nations, Satan have so much gotten their hearts, turned their heart against God, make them to forsake God Almighty that created them, who is the fountain of the living waters. We're going to pray. Say, Father, as many in your mercy, as many nations of the world that Satan have so much gotten their hearts, put them into the eternal damnation for them to reject you, Lord Jesus. Father, your mercy, Lord Jesus. Father, Lord, touch them, Allah, my Father. Give them the grace to repent and return to you in order to escape your wrath and anger in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, shall we pray.
Amen. Father, my Lord, my God, to
Father, Lord,
Thank you, Mother Holy Ghost. Jesus Christ, we have prayed.
Amen.
Pray for nations in the book of Psalm 33, verse 12. The blessed is that nation whose God is the Lord, and the people whom he had chosen for his own inheritance. We're going to pray. Say, Father, please, in your mercy, open the eyes of all the nations. Father, Lord, who have by themselves attracted causes to themselves, my Lord, my Father, by turning their back on you, by walking against, my Lord, my Father, your commandments, Lord Jesus. Father, please give them the grace to repent, that your peace and blessing, my Lord, my Father, will return back to them. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ,
amen.
Amen.
My God,
I want us to open our mouth and cry unto God again. Proverbs 21 verse 1. He said, the king's heart is in the hand of the Lord. As the rivers of water, he turned it to a sore river, he will. We are going to pray. Say, Father, my Lord, my God, because you hold, my Lord, my Father, the king, heart of everyone, every nation. Father, we therefore pray, Lord Jesus, as many nations, oh Lord Jesus, Father, Lord, that are under the rulership of dictators who have been saddled, my Lord, my Father, Lord Jesus, with demonic rulers, Lord Jesus. Father, Lord, arise, oh Lord Jesus. Liberate your children from such nations, oh Lord Jesus, that your children begin to know peace again, that your children begin to serve you, my Lord, my Father, in truth and in spirit, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, shall we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, my God, my Father, Lord Jesus, Lord, I by your Lord, in the power, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, God, arise, Lord,
We're going to pray for the servants of God all over the world. We all know now, everybody, even though that you did not get a coronavirus by yourself, you put yourself in a safe isolation so that you don't contract. But there are people, there are some servants of God who are in many regions that are very, very volatile, very, very risky. But they are there doing the work of God. We're going to pray for them. We're going to pray. Say, Father, in your mercy, continually, oh Lord Jesus, Father, Lord, guide my Lord, my Father. Protect, oh Lord Jesus. Empower all your missionaries, my Lord, my Father, Lord Jesus. My Lord and my Father, wherever they are doing your work, oh Lord Jesus. Empower them, my Lord, my Father. Incubate them. Father, Lord, immunize them, my Lord, my Father, divinely. Father, Lord, that this virus, my Lord, my Father, will not stop their work, oh Lord Jesus. And release upon them a fresh fire, oh Lord Jesus. Father, Lord, to disgrace every territorial spirit and powers in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, shall we pray.
Amen.
Father, in the name of Jesus, Father,
Father, we bring their word back to you because your word said in the book of Leviticus chapter 6 verse 13, it said the fire upon the altar will never go down. I'm going to pray. Say, oh Lord, my Father, Father, grant unto all your servants, Father, Lord, the power unto effective prayer, Lord Jesus. Any power, my Lord, my Father, Lord Jesus, fighting, my Lord, my Father, Lord Jesus, in order to bring down the prayer life of your servant, Lord Jesus, lay that power, my Lord, my Father, to live of ages, my Lord, my Father, grant my children, my Lord, my Father, power of effective prayer in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, shall we? In the name of Jesus, 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 in the name of J God, I want you to pray for our family as I pray for my own, and we use our families as to pray for every family of children of God. We're going to pray. Say, Father, every generation I curse, my Lord, my Father, Lord Jesus, Father, Lord, resulting from the sin of idolatry, Father, Lord, from my forefathers, oh Lord Jesus, Lord, that is now, my Lord, my Father, Lord Jesus, causing my Lord, my Father, a lot of problem in my family, Lord Almighty. You say, my Lord, my Father, King of all glory, that he that is in you, Lord Jesus, is not a new creation. Father, Lord, because I am in you now, oh Lord Jesus, Father, Lord, let every of such lineage, my Lord, my Father, let every of such transferable idolatry of sin, Lord Jesus, be separated from my family, Lord Jesus. Father, sanctify us with your blood in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
It can be said that God Almighty, he doesn't look for multitude. All his interest is just for one man. And who shall I send? Just looking for one man, and if he sees that right man or that right woman, he will do what he alone will do. That way affect other people positively. We're going to pray. We're going to ask God Almighty. Say, Father, I present myself as your son, as your daughter, to stand in the gap for my family. And by your authority, oh Lord Jesus, I break, my Lord, my Father, every form of untimely death, every form of barrenness, every form of stagnancy, every form of limitation, mm-hmm. Lord Jesus, physically, spiritually affecting my family. Father, Lord, I stand in the gap by your authority, and I break today in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, shall we pray.
Amen.
Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lord, I stand in the gap for my family. Every form of my family.
Here I am, God, Jesus. In the car of the Let your life be a blessing.
Even as we, children of God, it is always our prayer, the prayer of every true child of God, that their children will grow up, be able to take up a good part of you, good part that we are laying for them, the way of the Lord. So that's why we pray that our future generation, for them to take over. The same way our ancestral parents, because they don't know God, because they are into idolism, they will still say, on their demise, when they must have gone, that their children will follow so and so around. That's why there is power in blood. We're going to pray tonight. Say, Father, every vow or promise made by my ancestors, made by my grandparents, oh Lord Jesus, oh Lord, which is contrary, my Lord, my Father, to the divine purpose of my life, which is contrary to my divine destiny. Father, Lord, tonight, oh Lord Jesus, Father, me and my family, we lose ourselves from such vow. We lose ourselves from such promise in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, shall we pray.
Amen.
In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Soak each and every prayer we pray so far in the pool of blood of Jesus Christ, in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God bless you, son, unto the most eternal grace in Jesus' name. Brethren, let's open our mouth. In the first place, we are going to be praying for the unsaved and praying for God's revival upon the church revival, salvation for the unbeliever, but for the sake and empowerment for the Christians. So at the time like this, I want us to open our mouth and begin to bless the name of our God, who has given us the opportunity to come again to cry to Him. It makes us to understand in the book of Luke chapter 18, 1-8. Make us to know if the Luke, he said we should hear what the just say. Can him also not hear those that call upon him day and night? So let's thank him, because he shall hear us at the end. We shall all rejoice in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
My Lord, my God,
thank you. Thank you, Father.
Daddy, oh God, you
I give you all the praise
in the name of Jesus. And the Lord Jesus,
that you are
worthy, oh God, you are worthy.
Thank you, Lord Jesus, who loves us. Thank you, Lord Jesus, who loves us.
Want to pray that God in his infinite mercy that he should send that the fire of revival into the church of God according to what he said in the book of Joel. He said that the last day I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. That is revival. The church that is without the spirit of God, there is no revival there. It is the church that have the spirit of God that have revival. We're going to pray, Father, this, as we know that this is the last day, pour down your spirit and fire of revival upon your church, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ, as we pray.
Amen.
Father, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, Father, we are in the last and closing day of the Lord. There be a breakaway in the mighty name of Jesus, the Lord, the answer, the mind of protection, oh God. In the name of the Lord,
Father, come and be by your Lord, Father, have mercy, have mercy,
Father,
amen.
Every enemies of revival in the church of God, receive the wrath of God down and be consumed in the name of Jesus Christ. As we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Pray. Every agents of the devil that have been deployed from the pit of hell into the church, fellowshipping with the children of God, that is monitoring, waiting for the appointed time to divide the church of God. We are going to pray, Father, let your Koboko, Holy Ghost Koboko, begin to chase them out of your church now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ as we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus,
the Holy Ghost from above. We block every agent of darkness out of
the Bible says that because iniquity shall abide, the law of many shall wax cold. We are going to pray, Father, as many, O God, in the church of God, that their love for you have was cold. Have mercy and restore them back again with your fire in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Bible makes us understand that it's never the will of his for any to perish. That is why we are going to pray, Father, in your infinite mercy, let the angels begin to distribute, give them the power, release in them, Father, to begin to go and begin to share your salvational power. When Elizabeth, John, the two of them want to have children, it was the angel the Lord said, even we are going to pray, Father, distribute your angels upon the earth, O God, to begin to tell your children, Father, to begin to convert them. Grant them the power to our salvation, to begin to go all where a man cannot reach, for to share the gospel for divine salvation, that there will be salvation for many. As we pray in Jesus Christ's name, we pray.
Amen.
Release your wings of salvation. Release the breath of salvation upon the earth. It was when the Lord breathed upon the dry bone have life. Father, break the power of salvation upon it, that there will be salvation, that people will begin to run back to you and begin to repent from their sin and give their life to you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
According
to the book of Jeremiah and the book of Isaiah, the Bible says, by his strike we are here. We are going to pray for those that are sick. Lord, let it be that by your stride, the whole earth, as we know, the whole world is sick now. Father, by your stride, your word said that we are here. Let by your stride now, let healing begin to take place all over the earth, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, as we pray in Jesus'
name. Amen. Father, my Lord, my God, my Jesus Christ, Father, the whole earth, oh God.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. It move with compassion. It have compassion on them and it heal them all. We're going to pray, Father, look upon the earth with your eyes of compassion and let there be healing upon the earth, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ, as we pray.
Amen.
Father, my Lord, my God, Jesus, God, Father, please, God, look upon the earth, God, with your compassion, Father, have compassion, God, upon your children, make your eyes up, Father, Lord, God, you have mercy, Father, Jesus, in your word, you will have mercy upon you, you will have mercy, you will have compassion upon you, Father, Lord, I'm
Make us understand. As we all know, it is not by what, it's not by might, for by strength shall no man be made. We are going to beg God, Father, we
your strength, your spirit, your power upon it. Papa, and the reason why he told the apostle, don't go anywhere, go and stay in the upper room, is because you know they are empty. And because of that, they cannot walk effectively. We are going to pray, Father, and guide your children of your church, oh God, with the power from on high, that the power to be able to stand to the end and defend your name. In the name of as we pray.
Amen. Eternal Father, my Lord, my God, Father, and that also go Baba with your power from on high. Father, we need your power more than ever before. Father, please, oh God, that power of God, Baba, to do your will.
We are going to talk to God and say, Father, give us a lion heart. Give a lion heart to the church, oh God, to be able to say no to what you are saying no to. Yeah. To be able to say yes to what you are saying yes to, no matter what we come up at the time like this that we are. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, as we open our mouth.
So can seal up all the prayers with the blood of Jesus Christ.
Blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Bless you, sir, for the time. Amen. God bless you so far.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Every time I attended, when I was a child, until God is mercy, show me mercy. And after we become a watchman, the church itself is watching over. It has always be that whenever it's on, maybe there's crusade, any program is on, the choristers are always there at a lot. I've never seen where you'll be looking for a chorister to appoint, you will not see. That the mic is on, I mean off, or you will even be calling some from home. I saw, because they know, I don't know how God, who they think they are, they will purposely close their camera. Is it at this age where things are turning the other way? We are still feeling whatever. Some of us, we purposely close our camera so they'll come and start begging you. This time around, we are still behaving this way. Some of us, we purposely stay at home to come late. Because we feel without you, it cannot be done. Please let us be very careful. I've said this over. I've been looking for it, just 3 people. Out of we have almost 27, more than 27 or 30 choristers here. Only three. I know some of us work, but some of us are home yet. Some of us purposely come late. Is it good? Is it good? David said, God, use me now. I cannot praise you in the grave. God has shown you mercy to make it of you, yet you are misbehaving. I did not just jump to become a watchman overnight. No. I have done a prayer band leader by the grace of God. I have done evangelism leader by the grace of God. I have done so many things by the mercy of God. And by the grace of God, I put all my... I never do it as if I am doing it for the man of God. No. I don't do this to say, okay, maybe so that the man of God will see me. No. I do it as if I am even the pastor of the church. Maybe that's what God saw. I said, yes, my son. As he saw David, if David could take care of, could risk his life for the animals in the bush, he can risk his life for human being. Maybe that's what God saw. I said, this is my son. Your passion for my work, even when you're not a pastor, is enough. Take, go and leave my children back to me. Please let us be careful. Take apostle manner away from it. You are not serving me. I'm not serving you. You know, after the pastor, the next people are the choristers. In every church, if you don't, you better know that after the pastor, the next set of people is choristers. They must be there. Why? Men of God will be writing me. See, they are not there. Eh? As the prayer is going on, the monk God can just say, "Chorister, sing now." They are not there. Please. Let the choir mistress from today, if by tomorrow and for tomorrow it does not work, please, the mistress will start singing, you know, I tell you the truth, you can say, Apostle, I talk anyhow, it's not my business. I will tell you the truth. Call the choir mistress, please, go and, by tomorrow, position either 5, 6 people, choristers, please, arrange them. Say, tomorrow, please, this set of people rest well. Connect on time. These 5 people, Sister Ego, Sister Lisa, these 5 of you, be at alert. Next tomorrow, at least we have almost 30 so choristers on the mountain. We all cannot just be tired and come and every chorister just be sleeping. It's painful. I will have to start using photo to start calling someone at home. Why? We think God is happy. When God said, my children, will you go for me for this? We all say yes. We all say yes. Even my own wife, I will be using phone to, I'll be going by that. What is this? Eh? Will it be a good thing? I will say, Mr. Ferdinand, start singing now. Start singing. What will you do? Where we have choristers? It's like people don't know the position you are occupying. Which church will survive without vibrant choristers? Which church? Tell me, which church have ever survived without vibrant choristers? Eh? If a man of God is doing well, the choristers and intercessors must always be alert. If a church is on fire, the choristers must be at alert. Since I believe, where is this one? If I want to write this one, I'll just say, guys, I say, oh, look at that one now. I want to write this one. Only one that was really praying. Yes, we go, come, go. Some people just came and just, they even came late, I still lock up. Question, please go and arrange your home. Go and arrange your home. Go and do something about your home. We're in the battlefield. The Lord needs you people. We are in the battlefield. Sometimes I do what I'm not mentioning his name. When I start comparing. The choir, they are small children. Throughout the next, they are just there. Eh? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You cannot be there. Go start looking for other people. It's not good. I was not happy. When I even saw the staff leader came, I was happy. As he just came in, see lock up. Sister, I was calling her from home.
No, sir, because of my devices was some people when she was
calling. Don't give excuse.
I'm sorry, sir.
Sir, blessing, I was even calling her. She just came in. I was still locked up. My wife, I'll go there. She's still connected, locked up. Why? Or people who are not choristers, who are not even laborers. Look, sister Elizabeth. Them, they are doing it.
We are sorry, sir. Please, sorry, sir.
This way, Jesus Christ, my name.
Mm-hmm.
I want to pray. This is Christus now. I don't know what God is also saying about me. I don't know what God is saying about you. But wherever I've been a disappointment to you, wherever my work with you has been a disappointment to you, I make you happy for 2 days, I make you cry again on that 3 days again. I make you happy for 1 week again. Before I know it, you are crying over me again. Lord, have mercy upon me. And deliver me from such a spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. Open your mouth and pray.
Amen. Give me, Lord, in your nice and happy.
Let me say this to somebody here. If you are interceding on behalf of somebody, the Lord first must check you before you answer a prayer for that person. Before God could answer Nehemiah and Daniel, he knew that they would not disappoint him. He knew there are people who are consistent. Before the Lord will answer a prayer for somebody, you yourself must be right with him. You yourself, you will know that if by tomorrow you intercede for a person and that person is not with him, and you that intercede, you are no more there. It's appointment. So God would have asked some of us to deliver our family. But God does not trust us. He has seen that even if he bring them out now, because you are doing use by tomorrow when you disappoint him, all of them will go back again. So what do you need? What does he need? God does not trust some of us. I tell you the truth. Some of us, we are like liability to God. I tell you the truth. Our God. I want us to pray. Lord, wherever we have lost confidence in me, I have become an obstacle to the revival in my family. I have become an obstacle to the revival of the children of God because of the confidence you don't have in me. Father, I am sorry. Rebuild your confidence in me again. Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ, open your mouth
and pray.
The Bible says in Daniel 1 verse 8, Daniel proposed in his heart that he would not defy himself. And through art is life, he never. The Lord has confidence in Daniel all through. One thing that baffled me about Daniel is this. I did not see any place in the Bible. Daniel was called specially. There was special anointing. No, he prayed himself into God. Oh, God. Determination. How
they turned me away. There was no special man of God that came to lay hand on him and said, okay, now you have been called by God. No. The purpose of what he will do. And he met it. He met it. The problem we have today is we have not proposed really. Some of us propose, we are jumping up and down. Then he prayed himself into the ground. And today is one of the greatest man that ever lived. Why? Because he proposed and he stayed by it. The Bible said the woman with the issue of blood did propose in her heart, I will press myself, no matter the crowd, he must see me. In this program with Anna, what have you proposed? Even if the rest are weak, Lord, I'll be strong for you. Did you do so? So I know it's a battle. Even if others are stuck, I will be there for you. I know you need the man. I made myself available, and in sickness, I will be there. I tell you, people of God, since we started, the battle is on. I tell you the truth. Especially since the day he said, will you people go? I tell you, there are a lot of things going on. But we let give up. God forbid. God forbid. God forbid. And I need you to be strong for me too. I need the choristers to be strong. When I see that I'm strong, I will be more strong. I tell you the truth. When I see this man strong, I will be more strong. I think a lot of things are going on. I need Sister Esther. I need you. We need each other now. More than ever before. I need all the choristers more than ever before. Spiritually, a lot is going on. Physically, the way they are attacking the YouTube, everything, a lot of things going on. And I need you. God needs you. Just now, when it happened again, I want to go and watch. See, I saw there are all people who are online now. 80,000 people are watching. 4,000 people are watching. They don't watch them, but we, sometimes only 90 people, yet they are still removing it. For the past almost 2 weeks now, it has been battle. Sometimes you see me, I'll be off camera. I'm struggling here. He's struggling there. As we are doing it, they are removing it. As we are doing it, they are removing it. And after closing the game, battle continues. After closing, as some of us are sleeping, battle continues. I'm coming to the mountain again. I want to see. I want to pray. If I have not made up my mind for you, if I have not really made up my mind to stand for you in this generation, today, Lord, today, this prayer is not for everybody. It's for people who know what is happening at this time. Lord, if I have not really made up my mind before, today, I can see your pain. I can see your pain. I don't know if you are feeling what I'm feeling. I can see the pain going on in the heart of my father. Lord, I make up my mind today to defend your cause, to be there for you. Even when I'm sick, I will be there for you. Even when I'm tired, I know you will strengthen me. The Bible says, I can do all things. In Philippians 4 verse 13, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. All you need is to make yourself available. The Lord will strengthen you. Today, I make myself available for you. I am no more joking. I am no more doing it for anyone to see me. I am not doing it for you, oh God. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I'm going to pray. That power that is draining us, that is drilling our strength from us. I remember those days when we were home. My mother would go to the hotel and I say, my wife, come, let's go with you. With 9 children, my mother would go to the farm, would carry baby at the back. She will use that baby to weed. She will, after weeding, she will still go and use that baby to put cassava. As a cassava, I will see the baby with the guy with 2 legs on the back. So it will from back, throw the baby down and start breastfeeding. Oh God. We also before went to the farm now. She will be going with cassava. She will, if the baby cries, I don't know how they do it. It will, from there, behave and put in here. Baby will suck, it will be gone. Coming home, my father will be outside. She will still go and cook with that. And by 12 midnight, I will still hear the woman praying. Once it's 12 midnight, I will still hear this woman pray. She would pray to almost around 3 or so, say, what is this? I mean, every day, day in, day out. I don't believe this is ordinary. Something is happening. Something is drilling us. I say us now. Something is happening somewhere. We are too weak, I tell you the truth. Physically, spiritually, we are too weak. And this is not a church that is expecting rapture. This is not a church that is expecting to face this tribulation that's coming out. I don't think this is a church that's waiting for this tribulation or waiting for rapture. Is it Europe that has done this one to us now? Okay. If it's Europe that has done this one, they have done us bad. I remember those days when we are in night vigil. Now we are in the comfort of our house, yet we cannot stand for God. Would you like to go from Opoi to Irua? We'll still go there, still vibrate. But now, as that one is praying, is thinking about Jeep outside, one big Jeep, stainless Jeep outside. These are so comfortable. Fridge is loaded, everything is loaded. That's why the revelation God showed to Esther Joyce. I think about it all the time. Those who stood up were able to be writing. They are the one in Africa. They are the one in interior. But you that sat that comfortably to write, you could not write, you will still be distracted. They are those who are in Europe. All our comfort, we are still weak, we are still being distracted. But those who are in Africa, we are even praying with, they are so close to God. They are marching on. Lord, any power draining me, is it the food I am eating that is to kill me? What is that that is drilling us? Father, please have mercy. Deliver us from those things. Immune us against any power drilling us from you. Drain our strength that we are supposed to serve you. Deliver us from that power in the name of Jesus Christ. Open up that prayer.
In the name of Jesus.
We are going to pray to deliver ourselves from ourselves. Some of us, we have positioned our heart already. Be tired. What do I mean? You have already tell yourself, as I go to this work and come back now, I will be very tired now. And your body system has already tired already. As I'm eating this food, I know after this food done, it will go to sleep. You have told your body already. They say it. You it will happen. As I'm coming back from last now, this service tonight, I will be tired. You have told your system it must respond to you. And many of us have programmed our system into a tired system. Into a weak system. Even though when you're not trying now, no, the system has created it already. By so doing, you need to deliver yourself. Wherever I've positioned myself into a weak state, I position my intestine, my system into a weak state. And even if I try now, because you are giving that signal that you must be tired, they have been blended to eat. Eat and sleep. Go from work and be tired. It is programmed already. I disprogram that program now. My system receives strength now. I took you out of wherever I took you into. I took you out of weakness. I took you out of tiredness. I took you out of sleeping, sleepless, slumbering. In the name of Jesus Christ, open up that prayer.
Amen. Lord, my God, Jesus, I saw nothing.
I said,
Say, for the Lord shall be your confidence, and he will keep your foot from what? From stumbling. He will keep your foot from being taken, from being destroyed. I want to pray. I say, Father, from now on, I will not make myself my confidence again. I've tried myself failed me. I've tried my own strength, it failed me. I've tried my ability, it failed me. Father, from this moment, let your spirit be my confidence. And please keep my foot from slipping. Keep my foot from being taken. Help me, oh God. I surrender to the Holy Spirit of God today, not myself anymore. In the name of Jesus Christ,
amen.
Amen.
Amen. In the name of
The Bible says, "Strike the shepherd, the sheep will scatter." So long you are the one that God has called for now, until your husband come, you are the one God is seeing through to the family. Somebody hearing me? If it's your little child, the last born that no God, at that moment, that child becomes number one in that family. That's why you can see a church of old people. God will be using a little child. That child is the head, is the most senior in that church. Why? Because of the Spirit of God instead of him. What am I trying to say? Sister, brother, you are the one carrying the Spirit of God in your family. And the Bible has said it, strike the shepherd, the sheep will scatter. Now, imagine you are so weak that way. Imagine your people that don't even know God at all. What happened to them? If we, that are children of God, are so weak this way, what about our people that are looking unto us? They're in trouble. They're in trouble. I want you to pray. As many that my weakness have killed, as many that my weakness have subjected to torture, they got you weak in your weakness, your family that were committed to a fire, they get hold of them. Lord, as you are setting me free tonight, as you are rekindling your fire in me, everyone attached to me that are in prison as a result of my weakness, Everyone attached to me are in jail, spiritual jail, as a result of my weakness. Father, in your mercy, deliver them. Set them free to this hour. Deliver all of them in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You know why you must take this prayer seriously? Not until the Lord Jesus Christ resurrected from the grave and went after his disciples, they were still on your pardon. For hearing me. Immediately Christ was apprehended, all the disciples scattered. They are straight left there. Even when Mary and Andrew were going to tell them, yet they did not believe. Why? They believe their master is gone. Until you resurrect tonight, those in bondage, those who are looking up to you, they will never be set free. Until you, that the Lord has singled out of that family, until me have been rekindled again, until me and you have been, the fire is born again. Those people that are headbound, there's a problem for them. That's why you must pray tonight. Wherever I have been buried myself, as Christ resurrected and went after his disciples, Father, resurrect me, that through my resurrection, everyone in my family that are not hiding, that are not subjected to torture, might come out of their hiding place, might come out of their sin, might come out of their dungeon. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I want you, we are going to pray for ourselves. I will pray for myself, we're going to pray for ourselves. Wherever that the demon does not count you to be anything again, I know you are not there. You, even if you hurt now, before tomorrow you are gone again. We don't value your fire again because it's not consistent. Your fire is not consistent. Oh God, have mercy. We don't value you again. Your movement with God is not, it's a up and down. I beg, go away. Come, come, come. She's shouting. She's shouting tomorrow. Come and see her again. We now know her. We now know him. It's off and on. She's off and on. So we don't really value her. Let her put the fire. By tomorrow, we'll return back to her again. Because by tomorrow, we know her. We know him. She will not be there again. So we'll return back to her again. Let her pray herself out of it now. Don't worry. By tomorrow, we'll return back to her again. Because we know him. We know her. Is that how they are now making mockery of us now? Are the demons not so used to you and I now? Are the household enemy not so used to you and I now? Father, whatever that is making the enemy to make mockery of your presence in my life, wherever they have abandoned me and say, I believe I let you, this one is among them. Father, today let that be a change. Father, do something in my life that they will know of a truth. I am no more who they thought I am. Father, make me a brand new man. Holy Ghost filled person. Morning, night, and evening. Keep me burning. In the name of Jesus Christ. Open your mouth and pray. The Lord does not make use of people who are seasonal. People who produce they have season when they produce. That's why the Bible it shows us example. If where it was not yet the season for that fig tree, it's still burning down. So long as me and you, you must be in season all the time. You get what I mean?
Yes, sir.
If you are dealing with man, you can have season. If you is between you and your husband, you can have season. Maybe okay, hey, I'm not interested. That is between your husband. If you're between your God, you must be interested all the time. God does not have season. In every season, you must be there. That's why he told us in the book of John, chapter 4, verse 24. For God is a spirit, and they that must worship him must worship him in spirit and truth. You know why? The spirit has no season. It's always at a lot. Hello? That's why the Bible told us in Leviticus 6, verse 13. For the fire shall ever be burning upon the altar. It shall never go out, sister, so sacred, my mistress. Hear this, I said, my mistress. It shall never go out, always burning. For the fire shall ever be burning on the altar. It shall never go out. The fire of you being what God has called you must be burning all the time. Whenever God sees you and I, he must see us in a burning state. Give me fire in my life. Lord, keep me burning. Give me fire in my life. Lord, I pray. Give me fire in my life. Lord, keep me burning.
Keep me burning to the
brink of death. Keep me burning. Give me fire in my life.
It means some of us don't have all yet again in our land. As many, we're going to cry out, as many of us on this mountain, as many of the choristers, as many of the men of God, as many of the members, as many of us, that there are no more oil yet in their lamp. Maybe some of us is now remaining small. The light is now blinking and going. Father, refill us again with an overflowing oil. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, refill my oil. Refill the oil in my children. Refill my cup. The cup of my oil. Refill it to keep burning in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus. Father, your blessing. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Jesus Christ. Amen.
I want to pray. I say, Father, I want my lamp to be connected to heavenly visitation.
Amen.
I want my lamp to be connected. Not you refill it, you go. No, let it be connected to the spiritual fleet station in heaven. Powerhouse of God, where the oil is coming from. Connect my lamp to that place so that it will be burning all the time. Open your mouth and pray.
Amen.
I'm going to pray. So people can have oil, but yet they can't deal with it. I remember those days when I used to say to my grandmother that time, you know, there's one lab they used to do. They'll put oil in it. They'll put thread, something like thread. Is it thread? Cloth. That cloth or that's what you call it that time.
Rob
those
thread.
White, white.
Oh,
white.
Oh,
thread. Yeah, somebody just mentioned in the language. They will put it this way. This is the plate where they put the oil. This side will be inside the oil. This side will be here, burning. And the person must be at a lot. When they are born, you will shift it. You shift it again. You use it when you are home.
Yes, sir.
Different types, sir.
Exactly. So you will shift a little bit. So the person, you will not sleep and sleep off. Sometimes if you sleep off, you sleep and put your hand inside of it.
Mm-hmm.
For you. So you can actually have oil and you sleep on top of oil. I want us to pray. That spirit that will make me to have oil, have like, but yet I'll sleep on top of oil and light. Whatever that will make God to pour it and anoint upon me with all the anointing, yet I'm still sleeping on top anointing. What we call that, number one, problem. Any problem. Somebody getting me?
Yes, sir.
So people can sleep, but not because they are tired, but because of their head is full. Because the problem is not too much. They cannot do anything. They are anointed, but the problem have overshadowed the anointing. Lord, every load in me, every problem that have engulfed me, making me with all that the Lord has given me, yet I'm not able to perform because of the overwhelming problem. Father, let those problems give way today. You want to do your work. Over, please let all this thing be. Let this cup of problem overpass. Let this cup of problem pass me by. And I may be able to do your work effectively. In the name of Jesus Christ, open my prayer.
Amen.
I want us to pray. Whatever schedule I've given myself is against God's schedule in my life. Maybe I schedule myself that I'll be there this time, I won't be there that time. And God is saying, I want you to be there at that time. But since you are what called a free moral agent, God have left you to your own time. This is my program. This is my program. And God is saying that your program is against my program for you. I'll be there in the evening, I'll not be there in the morning. I'll be there in the morning, I'll not be there in the evening. I'm going to say, my son, my daughter, I want to be there. Lord, any program I have, this is against your program for my life. Any calendar I've marked for myself, and it's against your own calendar for me. I'm doing that my own. I'm so happy for it. And say, though you are happy, it's making me sad. Father, today let my own program submit your program concerning me. I give up my own program, my own test schedule, to take up your own test schedule for my life.
Oh, very important. My name is
Jesus Christ. Open my
name. Father,
in the name of Jesus Christ. Surrender all my program, Jesus, Father. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, my God, Lord Jesus, I give up my all my schedule that I'm studying for my time. Father, in the name of Jesus. Jesus, come up, Father, my God, Jesus, I give up my spirit. In the name of Jesus, come up, Father, and my God, Jesus, I give up my spirit. Jesus, Father, in the name of Jesus, come up, Father, and my God, Jesus, Father, Jesus, in the name of Jesus, come up, Father, and my God, Jesus, I give up my spirit.
I studied Elijah, Elisha, I studied Jeremiah, Ezekiel, Isaiah, just to mention a few. I saw they succeeded. Why? Because they never had their own program. They were always following God's program. Isaiah, go there. Okay. Whenever I'm reading Jeremiah and Ezekiel, I said, God, what is this? And the Lord said to me, and the word of the Lord said to me, such a person does not have his own program. You getting me?
Yes, sir.
Somebody like Elisha or Elijah, that God can look at it now to anywhere. You don't have your own program. That's why every true child of God must be at a lap of God, what you want now. Every true child of God is their life is now. Now, now. Now, and it was planned ahead, it's what God has planned for you. And I saw that's why they succeeded. Elisha can be here now. Elijah, you know it. So that is another place. Okay, now, let's see that is Old Testament. See the life of Apostle Paul. Get up. Go to Jerusalem. Get up. Leave here. They will not have me here. Go there. That is the life of the church. That's why the Bible says in the book of Romans 8:14, for as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are what? The sons of God. If you are the one making progress for yourself, that means you will surely make progress with your against God. Hello?
Hi.
If you are the one making progress for yourself, you will surely make the world be against God. You position yourself in an angle that God is saying, my daughter, not now, yet. I want us to pray again. I say, Father, from now on, be in charge of my daily program. Be in charge of my daily routine. Every morning, every night, he did not submit my tomorrow program for me. in the day, submit my next program for me so that I will not be walking, thinking I'm working with you. Meanwhile, I am far from you because I am what is programming myself. Open my eyes to always see your program, my daily program for me. In the name of Jesus Christ.
I speak as a wise man, judge you what I say. Now, look at this. You know why it's dangerous for you to make plan for yourself? No matter how perfect it is, you will be disobeying God. How? Let me explain to you. Maybe you are the one that by yourself make a plan that every 2 o'clock I'll be praying. It's your own plan. You are made a plan. If that 2 o'clock, Lord needs you to do something else, you will not do it. I'm not repeating.
Yeah.
I've made up my mind, my mind, that once it's 2 o'clock, I will off my phone. You know that God has told me to do it now. This is what I want to be doing. And by that 2 o'clock, if somebody that's about to die and God need me to pray at that time, if they call my line, they don't get me, I'm in trouble. So, some of our program have been making us to disobey God unknowingly. The program has said that at this moment, I will do worship. And at that moment, God is saying, my daughter, go and help me intercede for somebody. Though you worship and praise God, you'll be happy. At that moment, you are a disobedient child. But if the Lord himself make the plan for you, he will never thank, he will never ever obstruct it. Now, I ask myself a question. All those plans that I have been working with, who made it for me? All those have studied the word of God at so time. Who is the one that gives to you? If it's yourself that gives it, that means you have disobeyed God in one way or the other, or not to you. Now let's go to the Bible again. People who walk with God, God is the one that gives them what to do. Everyone that ever walk with God, their plan is being made by God. Noah. Walk with God. And people say, God said, Noah, this is how you do it. Like this, like this, like this, like this. And he did it that way. Now I asked you, those plans you made now, who made it for you? By Tuesday, I'll wait on God. Is it God that told you to wait on him on Tuesday? What about that Tuesday? God said, it's not me. I don't say you should go for me this day on your own. What will you do? Hello.
Hi.
Everything about God must be spiritual, not what I feel like doing. When it comes to God, you don't use feeling. I feel like fasting today. No. Don't feel like fasting. I feel like studying the Bible. You feel it? No.
When you go to God, you don't do feeling. It's either God is speaking or no. It's the body that has feeling. Hello?
Hi.
It's the body that has feeling. I feel like all those things. When it comes to the issue of spirit, you must be aware. The Lord is saying, I sense the Lord is talking to me. God, what are you saying? Say, I feel it. Feeling is for the body. But I want us to pray and say again, but I need the rearrangement of my routine. Everything I've ever planned for, by 6 to 3, I'll be praying. And it's not God that puts you in that position. At that moment, you off your phone, off everything. And at that moment, the Lord is bringing people to your way. Look, man, God is not an author of confusion. If God positions you at that place, He will never ever allow anything to distract you. So, God, I submit my daily routine to you. Check it. Which and which is against you? Which and which you did not plan for me, I plan for myself. Just to make myself happy. To tell myself, yes, I am working with God. Meanwhile, at that moment, I am far, far against God. Lord, have mercy upon me. Please open my ear to hear you, sister and brother. God still speak today. If God spoke in Old Testament, He spoke to Apostle Paul and the others in New Testament, why is our own different today? We God that we serve it. Lord, open my ears, open my spiritual ears to know your plan, my daily plan between me and you. In the name of Jesus Christ, open what I pray if you understand
what I'm talking about. Father, Lord Jesus, I give you the honor. Father, Lord Jesus, please open my ears, Lord Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father, open my ear, Lord Jesus, Father, to hear my daily prayer. In the name of Jesus,
mercy upon me, Papa, Father, come and reveal your
glory. I give you the title to my sister, to my
wife, from my eyes, O Papa, I hope to hear and to hear from you, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. My God, my Father, Lord Jesus, I have loved my ears, also hear from you, Papa.
Amen.
I read a post on Facebook not long this evening. People said, some people are praying for the healing of the nation. And why God himself, if I don't get it right, that why God himself is saying or praying, I don't know if he's praying or saying, it needs the repentance of the nation. So that's the way he put it. Father, have mercy on me if I don't get it well. They are praying for the healing of the nation. Lord, heal them from coronavirus, heal them from this. I didn't enter my healing can be anything. But say God is God, and why God is saying the other way around. You see why feeling is dangerous. I feel like you pray for people for coronavirus. Yesterday, something happened yesterday. As we're praying. We're praying. I don't remember the prayer we pray. I raised a prayer point about people that will be dying. As I raised it one or two, I stopped. I started raising prayer point concerning ourselves. All of a sudden, I feel wind from nowhere. And I was getting weak. I said, what's happening here? And I heard, he said, you have deviated from the prayer. The one you are not praying now is emotion. The one I tell you, you are not praying, you have left there. Go back to that prayer. I have to quickly return back to the prayer of people that are dying. That was when my eyes were not very clear to see them. That's why it's so dangerous. So I'm praying one prayer out of, I feel I should pray for these people. And God is saying, that is not what I asked to do. Most of sometimes we disobey God, thinking we are obeying Him. That's why the most dangerous life a man should live is following God badly. It's according to suicide mission. You hear that? According to suicide that, to follow God when you are not spiritual. I call it suicide that to be following God and you are not hearing Him, you are in danger. You are in a very big problem. To be serving the spiritual God in the flesh is a suicide mission. Yes, we're going to pray. Every suicide mission, I have a backup. Thinking I'm serving God. The Bible, I told Abraham, walk with me and be perfect. It means you should see the God is walking with. Hello?
Hi.
God said, walk with me. You should see the God you're walking with. You should be hearing the God you're walking with. And this suicide mission, I have a backup. Going to hell is suicidal. How can you go to heaven that God lives? And you say, which God? How do you get there? We don't hear Him. We don't see Him. He's not, how do you not get there? Wait, if they ask you, how do you not come? Okay, I was studying, but he said, Apostle Paul, I was not only studying, I was talking to Him too. Hello?
Hi.
Apostle, not only follow me by studying what God. I was also talking to Him what I wanted to do. The word of God is powerful, but there are some things the Lord will talk to you, it might not be there. If you want to kill you there, He can tell you, my daughter, don't go there. You can study the word of God, that was not there. Am I communicating?
Yes, sir.
That's why to follow God without hearing Him, we are committing suicide. It's an abomination. We are committing sacrilege. It's a taboo that needs to be delivered from. Father, deliver me from this suicidal mission. I have a backup. Save me. Deliver me. Before I give myself over to me, deliver me. I want to receive the God I'm working with. I want to be hearing the God I am working with. I want to be my God and hear my God. In the name of Jesus Christ. Among all the gifts of the Spirit, maybe casting out demons, there's a gift. Maybe see vision. That can be a gift. But this one is not a gift. Who can tell me that one?
Hearing the voice of God.
Hearing the voice of God is not a gift. That one is not among the gift.
designing spirit.
Design, see, that's a gift. Hearing the voice of God is not a gift. That will make you to become a bona fide child of God. Let me tell you something. You might not be born again. He can use you to cast a demon. I tell you the truth. Mm. Yes! Yes! That's why you can see men of God. They will be committed to adultery, whatever. They will still cast a demon. It's genuine. It's not. It's what they have been called to do. It's the gift you put to them. That's why on that last day, it will tell a worker of iniquity. I cast a demon. I preach your message. So that it will not tell that I didn't say you, but because you did it in sin, you are a work of iniquity. Oh. That's why I always tell people, don't be carried away with people being cast a demon. Mm-mm. Don't be carried away with the gift. Be carried away with the closeness between you and God. I'm a man of God, I'm saying this one now. That's why I am not moved when people say, this man of God is highly anointed. What is that? If after everything you are anointed, do not think you have, you are in trouble. But if you are somebody who hears from God, you will not make mistake. You can cast a demon, yet you don't hear God. You just use to cast a demon, walk and go. But you can't be there, you don't have all those gifts, but you hear your father talking. That is the best. He directs you, he leads you. He tells you what to do and what not to do. That is the best thing that can ever happen to a man. Say, my sheep hear my voice.
And they obey.
No. That is number one, to know if actually you are a child of God, to hear your father's voice and recognize him. When devil speak, you know, this is not my father. When your father says, yeah, this is my father's voice. But how will you know when he's not even talking to you? And he's even talking, you are not hearing. Why? Because either you are not really his child for now, or your ears have been loaded with so many things. But I tell you the truth, the best thing that can ever happen to a child of God is to hear the voice of God. It's for God to put his mouth in your ear. My daughter, this is the next step I want you to take now. My daughter, this, you are offending me. This way you are missing it now. My daughter, do this, my son, my daughter, do this. That is the best thing. You will not, you can never go to hell. It's not possible. You cannot be here, you can go to hell. It's not possible. It will always tell you where you are missing it. It's like, father, hey, divine, don't go there. Divine, you need to burn you. Go there. You run away from there. That is the best thing that can ever happen to a child of God. Lord, from this moment, whatever is blocking my ear to hear you, whatever that is making you to feel, is this actually my daughter? A sister called me one time, long time ago, about 2 years ago now. He said, Apostle Manuel, God bless you, sir. I said, God bless you. What is it? He said, you know what? God said, he's speaking. And you should tell God the same. I said, See, God said, he's talking to me. I should come and meet you to tell me what he's telling me. And you know what? Go and ask that God. If actually you are his daughter. If you are his daughter, I don't think he will tell me to tell you what he's telling you. And again, if you now say you are his daughter, ask him, what have you done that make you not to talk to you? Something must have happened that want to make me to become an intermediate between your father. Yes, sir. I heard him. I said, cool. Now, you heard him tell you that before you to have heard him, telling you to come and meet me. Tell him to just tell you what he's saying. So now what not stopping? If he can tell you, you heard him, to come and meet me, he should be able to tell you what he was saying. If he not tell you, you don't understand, come and meet me. I heard him. I did not understand what he was saying. I will not join you. Say, God, please tell me so that I will understand. See, that day was angry. She didn't come again. If it was some men of God, hey, yes. Now, it means God recognized me. He can just even be manipulated. I just be telling her I meet him. I say, I refuse to destroy myself for you. Go and meet your father. If it's your father, ask him, why does he not go? I have learned before. I learned for myself. He will call me. I have also learned. God said, from that day, I said, I will never stand against anybody here from the Lord. That is one of the biggest sins I think a man should commit. To try to stand in the way of people to become an intermediate between God and people is evil. And so many men of God does it. Some people does it. Lord, I want, if there's anything blocking me from hearing from you, Father, remove it. If there's anything that made me not to be your daughter or your son, Father, please deliver me from that thing. I want to be your daughter. I want to be your son. Please be speaking to me from now on. I'm tired of hearing from people to hear from you. I'm tired of telling people, what is God saying concerning me? Hey, is that not shameful? Is that not shameful? For me to say, hey, Sister Blessing, Sister Esosa, please, can you tell me what is God saying concerning me? What is that? If coincidentally, they're on the mountain, or God will say, my son, tell my daughter, that is, but saying you are not depending on me to be telling what God is saying, that is foolishness. Pray yourself out of it. If you have been depending upon, say, so Lord, Apostle Manuel is there. No problem. God will always tell him what to tell me. Ah, no, 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 no. Take me away from that position. If you have placed me in that position concerning in your life, please take me away from it. It's not a good thing. It's not a good thing. Just allow God. God has said, okay, my son, tell my daughter this. Not because you have put me in that position. I am not going to hear from God to come and tell you it's not a good thing. You know? That is evil. You are putting me in your position before God. I will never put any man in that position. God forbid. I will not do it. So I would also want anybody to do it to me. Even if God used me to speak to you, it doesn't mean, maybe as a watchman, you can know that I am not the one who will always come to you and say, hey, Sister Veronica, God say, Sister Esosa, God say, you are always waiting for me. No, 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 no. Take me out of that position. God forbid. God forbid. God should be able to talk to you every day. I may not be able to call you every day. That's why it's dangerous to make man your mouthpiece, to make man your ear, to make man somebody who will be talking to you. What God is saying? The man cannot be there for you all the time, but God will always be there. Lord, if there's any man I put in a position to always come and tell me what you're saying, I resent that person now. If it's me, give me a resignation letter. I will sign it. I tell you the truth. I will sign it. I don't want to be so to you. Mm-mm. Being a watchman does not make me to become little God over you. Mm-mm. It's not supposed to be so. We all should be able. Even you, God can still tell you, my daughter, I should tell my son, I can be busy. Tell my son, so. That is how it should be. That is how it should be. I tell you, you tell me, we tell each other. That's why I tell you, we are all children of God. Samuel, tell divine to give me water. Divine, tell Samuel to give me bread there. Salvation, tell, I should be able to say any of the message to any of them. If it's only Samuel now, Samuel, tell divine. Samuel, tell that one. They will say, hey, daddy, are we to be your son? Now, ask him now. That question. That's why some of you who are busy jumping up and looking for prophets, I pity you people. I pity all those people running up and down, spending money, looking for prophets who will tell them what saying, what are you doing? What are you doing to yourself? What are you doing to yourself? What? Now, what do you want that person to call you? If you're not ashamed, be ashamed of yourself now. How do you want that man to take you now? That man that you have taken, if this man does not tell you, you can never hear. How do you want that man to, first of all, you are sending that man to hell. Or not to you. You are sending that man to hell. You are building ego in that man over you or not to you. That's why I try my best to make sure if I am close to you, and I see you are not, I will withdraw again. I will draw again. Come again, withdraw. So that you not take me as if I'm a little God to you. We are all children of God. We all should hear from our Father. I want Sister Veronica to come and say, Apostle Manny, this is what God is saying. Yes. I want you, Sister Chidi, I want Sister Blessed to come and say, Apostle Manny, I will tell the Father, is it true? I'll say, yes, this is a daughter. Yes, this is actually a member of this ministry. I want to see people like that. If I have such people, this ministry is secure. But you see, it is only me that is saying, God say, hey, there's a problem. There's a problem. There's a problem. You have three children. Two are deaf. Only one is hearing you. Will you be happy? Who is that parent on this mountain who will have maybe six children? Five are deaf. Only one can hear you. That parent, you're in trouble. But if God bless you with children, all of them have ear to hear. Your legs are working well. Everything's working well. You'll be happy. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So you can see now, God is not happy because you are deformed. You are, for you not to be hearing, you are spiritually deformed. If you and I are not hearing God, it means we are spiritually deformed. No parents want to give birth to a deformed child. A child that is blind, you will not be happy to have it. So that child will become a liability to you all the days of his life. A child that is deaf, that child will be bringing shame and mockery to you. So, can you see how the Lord is being pained as me and you? Some of us, we don't hear, we don't see. He gave birth to a deformed child, God forbid. God cannot give birth to a deformed child. Today, every spiritual deformity in me, heal me from it, Lord. We'll stop with this because we have no time to go. Every spiritual deformity in my life, deliver me from it. Was I born deaf and dumb, blind? The day I gave myself to you, was I born deaf? Please heal my deafness. Was I born blind? Heal my blindness. I want to see and hear from now on. I tell you, every other deformities is unmanageable, but blindness, oh God, deafness is horrible. They'll be saying something about you, you will not hear. Oh God, you're in trouble. Every spiritual deformity in me, maybe your own is crippled. You're spiritually crippled. Father, heal me. Maybe you're spiritually handicapped. Father, deliver me. I want to be well or true. I want to be spiritually sound. Let all my spiritual sensitivities be working fine. Let all my spiritual organs, let all start working from now on. In the name of Jesus Christ, open your mouth and pray.
Amen. Amen. Father, Lord Jesus, Father,
Thank you. For you have done well in my life today. I know from now on, my family, my loved ones, everyone connected to me, they are saved now. Open your mouth and thank the Lord Almighty.
Amen.
I want us to pray, Lord, as you purge me, as you purify me from every sin that used to make me, I will hear today, tomorrow, I will not hear again. As you purge me today, as you have forgiven me, I soak myself in your blood. Let your blood preserve me. Let your blood help me to go and sin no more. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That's what I pray, so shall it be in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Amen.
So, Senosa, please lead worship for 5 minutes. Please, 5 minutes. I know why. Before we go.
Lion of Judah, I worship you. Lion of Judah, Lord, you are holy. Lion of Judah,
I worship you. Lion of Judah, Jesus, you are holy. O Lion of Judah, we worship you. You are the Lion of Judah, Jesus. You are holy, Lion of Judah. Lion of Judah, we worship you, Lord.
We worship you,
Lion of Judah.
Lion of
Judah. Holy Daddy,
you are holy.
You are God from the beginning to the end. You are the Lion of Judah. There is no argument, Lord. You are God, Daddy. From the beginning to the end, Lion of Judah, Daddy, you reign forevermore. You are God.
You are God.
From the beginning to the end. Lion of Judah,
Lion
of Judah, there is no
argument.
You are God.
You are God.
Oh, yeah.
From beginning to the end,
you Father, you are King.
You are King.
From the beginning to the end. You are the creator of heaven and earth, oh Lord. There is no argument about it.
No controversy.
You are the King of all kings. From the beginning to the end. You are the Alpha and Omega, Daddy. You reign forevermore. You are God.
You are God.
That's who you are.
From the beginning to the end.
The Lion, Daddy.
No. You are God. From the beginning
Father, you reign forever. You are mighty, Lord. You are mighty, Lord. Jehovah, you are mighty. Father, you are mighty. Jesus, you are mighty. Savior, you are mighty. Sing it one more time.
You are mighty, Lord.
Sing it to me.
You are mighty, Lord.
I want you to, in the next 5 minutes, talk to God. I will lead you. Talk to God. Talk to your Father. You don't say it out. Just talk to God. Apart yourself. What you are happy with, what you are not happy with. Maybe in all, I did not mention it. With all I've said, Lord, I need to say, you know yourself. You know where you are struggling. I came up just now, call it out and all, but you know the reason, you know what is happening to you. The Bible says, as I'm talking, be praying, to the extent Eli, the man of God, did not understand what Sister Anna was going through. He said, Anna, this morning you are drunk. He said, I am not drunk, you don't understand. Apostle Manny might not understand. I believe, as I was told, just I said, if this man understand, this man just saying, call this as now, I wish he understand. My own is to see you doing the work of God. My own is to see us work and make it into heaven. But you understand what I don't know. She was accused of to be a drunkard. But you say, man of God, I am not drunk. It's out of the pain in my heart and pouring my heart to God. Some of you want to be early, but you know why. So say to God. Say to God. Tell it to Jesus. Tell it to Jesus. What is the problem you cannot tell any man? Tell it to Jesus now. Tell it to Jesus Christ. Tell it to Jesus Christ. What is the issue you cannot tell any man? Tell it to Jesus now. Maybe you cannot even tell your brothers. Maybe you cannot even tell your spouse. Tell it to Jesus now. Tell it to Jesus now. He's hearing you just as he heard Hannah. He will answer you just as he answered Hannah. Tell it to Jesus Christ now. What is that thing you cannot tell Emmanuel? Tell it to Jesus Christ now. Tell it to Jesus Christ now. He's the only one that we understand. tell it to him now. I may not understand. You may not understand me, but the Lord knows all that we are going through. Let us tell it to him now. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus Christ's mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
And the God who heard and hear in secret shall answer you openly, and you openly give the testimony of the secret prayer you have prayed to in this hour in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Sister, what's her name again? She was not angry when Ella said she was drunk, but rather she used wisdom to pray a prayer, and Ella pronounced upon her. That's why it said, "Blessed are they who are not offended in me." So if you're offended, the way I spoke just now, please don't be offended. All I want is that for you and I to make it to heaven. And I pray, as Eli pronounced on Hannah, as she went home and came back with testimony, I pronounce upon all the choristers on this mountain, whatever that behold you bound, whatever that not allow you to be what God desires to be, I command that thing to give way now for you to serve your God the way He wants to serve Him in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
From now on, testimony is yours in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That's on this mountain. I pray for every soul on this mountain, whatever you are struggling with, whatever that be an obstacle, that be a wall of partition between you and your destiny, between you and your God, I command that to give way now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As Hannah came to the Lord, to the house of God, and give testimony and submitted Samuel, so shall you also bring your Samuel, whatever that Samuel might be. The Lord has also given it to you. You also come and present it to God in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It is well with us all in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen. Amen.
You are there, you're not born again. Please, for it to be well with you on earth here and be well with you on the last day, you must be born again. The Bible says, as many that receive, He gave power to become sons of God, and as many that refuse Him, they are dead, they are condemned while they are yet alive. Choose this day. Either to be blessed, be condemned. But I counsel you to give your life to Him so that you become a blessing even to the blessed people. Confess your sin before the Lord and accept Him as your God, your Father, your everything. And let the angels in heaven rejoice over you. And as you do so, I pray God Almighty will sustain you, empower you, You will never know the way back to sin, to that world again you were before, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. As many of us, maybe we were offended because of a problem or whatever you backslided. And as you have come back to the shepherd and the bishop of your soul, that child, the prodigal son, never returned back to that far country. You will never ever return back to that faculty of sin again in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
For those of us who don't come on again, please, I want you to get baptized, which is the next step you need to take. And if you wish to be baptized, please, I want you to call on the ministers of this mountain. And the Lord, in His mercy, we humbly use them to glorify Himself in your life, to cancel you when necessary, and to baptize you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Let us pray. Father, we thank you. We bless you. We worship you. We thank you for all you've done. Man, Bible say, whatever I tell, when I tell all. Lord, you have spoken to the corridor, to the corridor, you enter every one of us. So God, we are happy that we have a Father who don't neglect us, who don't abandon us, who always chastise us for us to be what you destined us to be. Father, we have heard you. We have learned. We have prayed. And I know you have answered us. Help us to go and sin no more and to become that child, that children you want us to be for you. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Father, that don't go born again. As you are also dealing with us, oh God, Father, deal with them also in that way. Father, so that on the end we'll be happy you flogged us into your kingdom, not to be pet into hell. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
Everything you have done, I know the devil is so tricky. You want to come out, use stylishly to come out and do it. Father, put a wall around everything you have done for us, and that the devil shall not be able to undo any of them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I hear thus says the Lord, genuine in our homes, Father, in this ministry, all your children will start hearing from you. We all start hearing from you. Nothing shall be hidden from us in our family in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. Father.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Strengthen me, empower me. Every power fighting day and night to see that I am brought down. Father, you have helped me to conquer them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. At the end of this journey, I and every soul you have brought to this ministry, we all shall joyfully see you in heaven. We shall ever live and reign with you forever in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
You are blessed tonight. Give me close to not celebrating.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
God bless you, man of God. May the Lord God Almighty continue to empower you. May He continue to uplift you, safeguard and protect you. More grace, more wisdom, more of Him in your life in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The eye of God continue to watch over you and the entire family to the end in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Love it. It is all free time.
I give you thanks, there is no one like you. We give you thanks, there is none beside you. We give you thanks, none like you, Lord. Mighty God, everlasting King, hallelujah.
We give you thanks, there is no one like you, Lord. We give you thanks, there is no one beside you.
We give you
thanks,
all like you, Lord.
Mighty God, everlasting.
one more time. We give you thanks. There is no one like you. We give you thanks.
There is no one beside you.
We give you thanks.
Our beloved Paul, our beloved brother Jules Johnson, God bless you, sir. Please you stand by for our monthly and yearly declaration. While the closing prayers be taken by beloved Minister Ferdinand. God bless you, sir. I quickly want to welcome the newcomers in our midst. If you are worshiping with us for the first time, you are in the right place. This is Mountain of Solution and Redemption Prayer Ministry Worldwide, the place of hope, peace, comfort, and salvation. We welcome you in Jesus Christ's mighty name. Please kindly wait behind after closing to see the available men of God to reach the men of God on this mountain for counseling, for directions, and for other information. Please kindly contact us with this number, which is +491 5211 33 4015. You can also visit our website. There you can get all the relevant information. Also, certain things that can also grow your spiritual life. Kindly visit our website, which is www.msropm.org. I repeat, www.msropm.org. And as you do so, the Lord God Almighty bless you in Jesus Christ's mighty name. Amen. Amen. Beloved, all of that information still remains the same and authentic. Our next meeting will be 11 a.m. Central European Time. May God bless and empower us all in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Lord, please repeat after me as we say, a month and yearly prophetic focus. I declare that the month of April.
I declare the month of April
is my month of uninterrupted love for God.
It's my month of uninterrupted love for God.
In complete submission to the Holy Spirit.
In complete submission to the Holy Spirit.
In Jesus Christ's mighty name.
In Jesus Christ's mighty name.
And I also declare that the year 2020.
And I also declare that the year 2020
is my year of steady and perfect walk with God.
It's my year of steady and perfect walk with God.
In complete holiness and true righteousness.
Come, righteousness.
In Jesus Christ's mighty name.
In Jesus Christ's mighty name.
As we all declare, so shall we be in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Let us pray. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And most holy Father, we thank you, we worship you, we adore you. We give you all the glory, honor, and adoration, Lord Jesus. Father, Lord, you never change for whom you are. Of a truth, my Lord, my Father, you are taught, my Lord, my Father, for we, your children, is taught of good and never evil. Father, Lord, you are never tired, my Lord, my Father, of speaking to us, admonishing us, chastising us, my Lord, my Father. King of all, glory of all, Lord, we appreciate you and magnify you. Thank you, my Lord, my Father, for guiding us again, Lord Jesus. Thank you because you have moved, my Lord, my Father, in a different way, my Lord, my Father, tonight. Lord, we give you glory, we give you honor. Father, everything you have done tonight, my Lord, my Father, King of all glory. Father, Lord, we pray that it shall be permanent, that no power of the enemy can ever and turn it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Our Lord and our Father, King of all, Lord of all, Lord, my Lord and my God, Father, a seed, my Lord, my Father, have been sown in our life again. Father, Lord, King of all glory, that spiritual seed, O Lord Jesus. Father, Lord, we pray, my Lord, my Father, that the Lord, that this seed, my Lord, my Father, they continually sow in our life. Father, no power can ever choke it, Lord Jesus. Father, Lord, it will, my Lord, my Father, germinate and bear positive fruit. Those fruit, my Lord, my Father, that will enable us to see you in glory on that last day in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Of all, Lord, we thank you, worship you, my Lord, my Father. Thank you, my Lord, my Father, for your servant to whom thou have used tonight, Lord Jesus. And every other vessel that you have used tonight, my Lord, my Father. Lord, we pray that virtues must have led them, Lord Jesus. You control the plenitia children, my Lord, my Father, King of all glory. My Lord and my Father, Lord Jesus. You are oil upon your children, my Lord, my Lord and my Father, will never go dry. King of all glory, any power, oh Lord Jesus. Fighting, my Lord, my Father, to bring your children down, Lord Jesus. Father, Lord, you will arise and fight the battle, Father, Lord. And victory, my Lord, my Father, and testimony shall be ours in the mighty name of Jesus
Christ. Amen.
Lord Almighty, we thank you, worship you, Lord Jesus. Father, Lord, at the end, my Lord, my Father, Lord Jesus. Father, your mercy, your grace will stand, my Lord, my Father, for your servants, Lord Jesus. Father, Lord, to be able to enter and receive that incorruptible crown waiting for them and each and every soul in this mountain in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Lord, we thank you, we worship you. Father, we are going now, my Lord, my Father, for a brief rest, Lord Jesus. Father, grant us, my Lord, my Father, a sound rest, O Lord Jesus. Father, we come against, my Lord, my Father, every spirit that brings nightmare. Father, Lord, it will never be a portion in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, Lord, we and our children, my Lord, my Father, by your mercy and grace, hide us in the hollow of your hand in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, my God, King of all glory, as he pleases you, O Lord Jesus, none of us shall sleep a sleep of death, but by your mercy and grace, we will all wake up, my Lord, my Father, like a giant in you, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We thank you, Lord Jesus, our tithe and offering, Father, Lord, as we bring you before you. Father, we pray, my Lord, my Father, please, my Lord, my Father, sanctify them, Lord Jesus. Let them be acceptable in your sight and be used, my Lord, my Father, for your purpose, in the name of Jesus
Christ. Amen.
Amen. Father, thank you, Mother Holy Ghost. We give you glory, we give you honor, for in Jesus Christ's holy name, we all have prayed with thanksgiving.
Amen. Amen. The grace in fellowship. And the grace of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ,
Lord of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit.
Christ.
Beloved, in one accord, let us shout, have mercy upon us, O God, in the name of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ.
Have mercy upon us, O God, in the name of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ.
Victory in the name of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ.
Victory in the name of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ.
And glory be to our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ.
Glory be to God, Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Beloved, as we are all going, the presence of God will go with us and remain with us. And may the Lord God Almighty give us the grace, the serving to the end in holiness and true righteousness, strengthen us to the end, empower us all. And may the peace of the Lord God Almighty abide with us and with our family in Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen. Amen.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye, sir. Bye for your day. Bye. Bye.
Bye, brother Mike.
Quickly, I want to tell you something.
Me?
It's like it's brother Mike talking to Sister Antonia.
Okay.